Hello students, and today we are going to start the condensers part of this first chapter. And in today's lecture, we are going to study the different types of condenser. What is the condition for the condensation process in case of the thermal power plants? Okay, and what are the functions of different condensers and how their construction differ from each other and where are their applications? Okay, so let's start with the condenser parts. So starting with the steam condensers, first of all, condensation. What is condensation? So if the pressure of the exhaust steam reduced below the atmospheric pressure and hence its energy partially or fully cannot be reutilized, then this phenomena is called as steam condensation. So actually, what is in the simple language, what is the process of condensation? That is the conversion of steam back into the water. And in this conversion process, the pressure reduces below the atmospheric pressure. Okay, this is the main condition, that pressure must be less than the atmospheric pressure, because we know that when the steam is taken from the boiler, it is at very high pressure. Because that high pressure should be then able to rotate the blades of turbine. And so the steam is at very high pressure in the turbine stage also. So in case of condensers, we have to first reduce the pressure. And what is the limit for that reduction? That it must be below the atmospheric pressure. Okay. And then this conversion of steam into water is called as the condensation process. Now, what are steam condensers? The heat transfer device, as we see here, that the heat is transferred. Okay, the steam is at very high temperature. And when we convert that steam into the water comes out at very low temperature. Okay, the heat transfer device in which the exhaust steam of a turbine or an engine is condensed by means of cooling water at pressure below atmospheric pressure is called steam condenser. Okay, actually it is a device which converts high pressure, high temperature steam into the low pressure and low temperature water. Okay, so this is the main process which is done in this device. Okay, I'm again repeating, in this process of condensers or in this heat transfer device, high pressure is converted into the low pressure and high temperature is also converted into the low temperature. Okay, and the final result is water from steam, and that water is a pure water, which is again fed to the boiler and recirculated in the complete process, like from boiler, then to turbines, then to condensers, and again to boilers, and so on. So this cycle goes on, especially in case of the thermal power plants. Now, what is condensate? The condensed steam is called condensate. Okay, here I have earlier said that steam is converted into the water. And this water that is obtained from the steam coming from the turbine is called as condensate. Okay, so we called this condensed steam as condensate and can be again returned to the boiler. It saves the cost of water that is fed to the boiler, because we know that for boilers, whether it is a fire tube boiler or a water tube boiler, we want pure water that must not contain any type of impurities, okay? Any type of dust particles or any type of stones or some minute particles. There should, water should be pure, and that pure water is obtained from condenser, okay? And which we called as a condensate because it is condensed from the steam, and that is also a pure steam. Now, the principle of working of the condenser, that is the principle of condensation. See here the just graphical representation of the pressure. Okay, see here the pressure. This is the different stages. Now, just study, I am In order to attain the maximum work, according to the Carnot principle, so these are the different principles that we have to study in our next chapter, that is the Carnot cycle, then Rankine cycle, then binary vapor cycle, and so on. So according to the Carnot cycle, so this is the principle, in order to attain the maximum work, according to Carnot principle, the heat must be supplied at maximum pressure and temperature. So maximum work is done in the case of turbines and boilers, which get the steam at maximum pressure and maximum temperature. Very high pressure and temperature is there in the case of turbines and boilers, and should be rejected at minimum pressure and temperature. And this condition of minimum pressure and temperature is the stage there at the condensers. Okay? That means in case of boilers and in case of turbines, the pressure and temperature is very high. Whereas in case of condensation stage, the pressure and temperature is very low. And these conditions must be achieved to get the maximum work out of that particular steam. Okay, so see here, this first stage from 1 to 2, this is generally the boiler stage, okay, boiler turbine stage. Then this pressure is reduced to number three stage. And from number three, if it goes to 4 and 4 to directly 5, so that means the condensation does not take place properly. Okay, because for condensation, we want that the pressure must reduce below the atmospheric pressure. And this is the line for atmospheric pressure. And so for proper process of condensation, the line 6-7 have to be followed. If the line 4-5 occurs, that means the steam is not properly condensed. Okay, so for proper condensation, the line 6-7 have to be followed. That means the pressure must reduce below the atmospheric pressure. Just see here, the steam from the steam turbine or the steam engine could be exhausted to atmosphere in such a manner that the back pressure would below the atmospheric pressure. That means the pressure is reduced in such a manner that it must be below the atmospheric pressure at stage number 6. Now, what are the advantages of condensers? It increases the work output per kg of steam supplied to the power plant. Second, it reduces the specific steam consumption. Okay, because that steam is again recirculated, so it reduces the wastage. It reduces the size of power plant of given capacity. Okay, if we have to feed the fresh water again and again to the boiler, and so for that fresh water you need again the different types of filters. Okay, a large setup is there. So if the steam taken from the condensers and fed to the boilers, so the size is also reduced. We don't need that much devices for the filter circuits. It improves the thermal efficiency of the power plant. Okay, how it improves the thermal efficiency? Because the water that is taken from the condensers and that is fed to the boilers again is a hot water. Okay, that means that condensate is already hot in its hot state, and so it takes less time to be converted into the steam. And if a cold or fresh water is fed to the boilers, so it takes more time for its conversion into the steam or the superheated steam. Okay, it saves the cost of water to be supplied to the boiler. Okay, so it also saves the cost of water because we don't need fresh water all the time. We can circulate the same water in the same process of boiler, turbine, condenser, then again boiler, turbine, condenser, and so on. So it saves the cost also. Now, the basic circuit or arrangement for the condensing plant. So it consists of, see here, the different parts or the different devices in this condensing plant. The first one is the condenser. See here, this center portion, this center oval shaped, this is the condenser. Okay, and here it is the exhaust steam from turbine. What is the input to the condenser? Input to the condenser is the steam that is exhausted from the turbine, taken from the turbine. Okay, and what is there here? There is some river or lake must be there for the circulation of cold water into the condenser, because with the help of this cold water only, the steam taken from the turbine is converted or it is condensed. Okay, so the water is taken, see here, this arrow, follow this arrow, water is taken through some circulation pump. Okay, water is taken through this circulating pump and then it is fed to the filters, because the water which we are going to enter into the condenser, so that must be a pure water again. So we need filters. Okay, so this filter removes the impurities from the water that is taken from the river, and it is used here in the condenser for the process of condensation. And when the steam is condensed, it is again sent back to the river. Okay, so this water is recirculated here, taken from the river and again goes to the river. Okay, and here in this condenser, there is also one more pump, that is the air extraction pump, which sucks the air from the atmosphere and sends here to the condenser and then again send back to the atmosphere. Okay, and when the steam is condensed properly, or when it is converted into condensate, that condensate is extracted using again one more pump is there, that is the condensate extraction pump. Okay, by using this condensate extraction pump, the condensate is collected in some space. We call that as a hot well. Okay, and from this hot well, it is fed to the boiler by using a feed pump. So how, see here, how many pumps are there? One is the circulation pump that is connected with the river. Okay, another is the air extraction pump that is extracting the air from the atmosphere. One is the condensate extraction pump to collect the condensate from the main condenser body. Okay, another is the feed water to boiler pump, that is the feed pump. So there are four types of pumps in this whole working process. Okay, now let's read these. So condenser, in which the exhaust steam of the turbine is condensed by circulating cooling water. Okay, so by circulating the cooling water from the river or the lake, so that steam that we have taken from the turbine is condensed into the water, into the condensate. Condensate extraction pump, that is to remove the condensate from the condenser and feed it into the hot well. So here it is the condensate extraction pump, that is to collect the condensate from the condenser and put it into the hot well. The feed water from the hot well is further pumped to the boiler using this feed pump. Okay, then air extraction pump, to remove the air from the condenser, such a pump is called dry air pump. That is, any air there in the condenser, to remove that air, that is the air extraction pump is there. If air and condensate both are removed, it is called wet air pump. Because in our further classification, so sometimes we have to use a dry air pump that removes only air. Okay, And sometimes the same pump is used to remove the air as well as to remove the condensate. And we called that pump as wet air pump. So there are two types of air pumps. So this is they are used as per the classification. Okay. So one is the circulating pump is used to supply the feed water either from river or from the cooling tower pond to the condenser to supply the water from any river. And here the filters are attached with this circulating pump. Now, what is cooling tower? As you have seen somewhere in the thermal power plants, the very large cooling towers are there. Okay, very big in size. So these are the ferro concrete made device, hyperbolic shape hoti hai iski, like this. This is a shape for the cooling towers, and in which the hot water from the condenser is cooled by rejecting the heat to current of air passing in the current direction. Okay, so from here, the circulating pump, there is some pond connected with the base of the cooling tower. Okay, here water is taken through some circulating pump. Okay, and that water is fed at some height in the cooling tower. And then again, it is sprinkled here to lower the temperature through some nozzles. Some nozzles may be there. The ring troughs are placed 8 to 10 meter above the ground level, through which this water is sprinkled into the cooling water. See here, the water is taken from the pond, circulating pump. It is rotated in the condenser where the steam is converted into condensate. And then this hot water, because that water now becomes hot, and it is sprinkled by using these ring troughs with nozzles. Some nozzle arrangement is there, and it is again sent back to the pond. Now the different types of condensers. So there are two types of condensers. One is jet condensers and other are surface condensers. So just see the definition first. In case of jet condensers, the exhaust steam that is taken from the turbine, okay, and cooling water that is taken from the pond come in direct contact, and as a result the steam is condensed. Okay, so what is there in the jet condensers? Here the steam that is taken from the turbine and the cooling water which is used for the condensation process from the rivers or pond, they come in direct contact with each other. Okay, they mix with each other and that steam condenses properly. But there is one main drawback in this case of jet condensers, that in this case, we have to assemble some filters also after the condensate collection stage. Okay, because the water that is taken from the river or lakes, etc., that maybe not in the pure state, okay, that may need some filters, okay, some impurities may be there. So in this case, some extra filter circuits are required. But in case of this category, the steam comes in direct contact with the cooling water that is taken from the ponds or lakes. And in case of surface condensers, the cooling water flows through the network of tubes, and the exhaust steam passes over these tubes. The steam gets condensed due to the heat transfer to coolant by conduction and convection. Okay, so what is there in the surface condenser? The cooling water flows through the tubes and the steam is there all around that tubes. Okay, it is a type of jaise water tube boilers mein tha ki the water is there in the tubes, and here it is not the hot gases, here it is the steam that is all around that tubes. And when that steam comes in contact with cooling water tubes, so that steam condenses and converted into the condensate, and that is collected by using condensate extraction pump. Okay, so this is the surface condenser. So what is the major difference between them? That here the cooling water and steam is in direct contact with each other, whereas in case of the surface condensers, the cooling water and the steam are not in direct contact with each other. Okay. And further now comparison, steam and water comes in direct contact, whereas in case of surface condensers, the steam and water does not come in direct contact. Okay. Condensation is due to the mixing of coolant. When the coolant or cooling water mixes with the steam, then the process of condensation takes place. Whereas in case of surface condensers, the condensation is due to the heat transfer by conduction and convection. Third point, condensate is not fit for use as boiler feed until the treated cooling water is supplied. So advanced filter circuits are required for this. Okay, only then that condensate is fed to the boiler again. Condensate is fit for reuse as boiler feed. So here the condensate that is collected is directly fed to the boiler without any filters. And in case of jet condenser, it is a cheap, does not affect plant efficiency. Iski cost less hai. It is costly and improves the plant efficiency. Here the efficiency is high, okay, but it is costly because some network of tubes must be there that must be constructed within the condensers. So that's why it is costly. Maintenance cost is low. Here the maintenance cost is high, okay, because the regular maintenance of that tubes is required. Here the vacuum created is up to 600 mm of Hg, and here the vacuum created is up to 730 mm of Hg. So if the efficiency point of view, so surface condensers are better than the jet condensers. But if the cost consideration is there, then jet condensers are better because they are cheap as compared to the surface condensers. But generally they see the efficiency must be their maximum work output is there. So generally the surface condensers are employed. Now starting with the jet condensers. So the different types of jet condensers are, the first one, low level jet condensers. And under the low level jet condensers, there are further two types. One is the counter flow type and parallel flow type. Then there are high level jet condensers. Then ejector jet condensers. Okay, so these are the different classification for jet condensers. So starting with the low level counter flow jet injector. Okay. And this is the figure for the jet condensers, low level jet condensers. And see here, the main basic parts are the same that we have seen earlier, that there are four pumps are there. There is a cooling pond. There is the main condenser shell. There is the hot well. So just the difference is the arrangement or what is there in the condenser. That is the main difference. Okay. Now see here, this is the condenser. And from here it is exhaust steam. Okay, this exhaust steam is taken from the turbines. Okay, firstly the exhaust steam is fed to the turbine, and as the steam is lighter, so it tries to move upwards. Okay, tries to move upwards, and there are some perforated trays which have some holes or net type structure is there, and here it is the air extraction pump. It removes the air, any air from the condenser shell. This is the condenser shell. Okay, here is the air extraction pump. And which air extraction pump is used here? Here it is the dry air extraction pump because this removes only the air. Okay. And here in the downward direction, there is the condensate extraction pump. And when this water is condensed, steam is condensed to the water, then here it is the condensate extraction pump. And here it is the cooling pond from where the cooling water is fed to the condenser shell. Here it is, you have also to install here one pump also to get the cooling water from the pond. Okay, and then that water is fed to the condenser shell, which helps in the condensation of this steam. As it is a jet condenser, so here the steam and the cooling water is in direct contact with each other. Okay, there is no any network of separate network of tubes for this cooling water. The cooling water is sprayed over these perforated trays, which helps in the process of condensation. And here, by using this condensate extraction pump, the condensate is collected and sent to the hot well. Okay, from where it is fed to the boiler, or some of the extra water is again fed back to the cooling pond. Okay, this is the overflow pipe. Extra water is again fed back to the cooling pond. So this is the main construction for the counter flow jet injector, low level counter flow jet injector. The cooling water to be lifted into the condenser up to a height of 5.5 meters. So this water, cooling water, is lifted up to the height of 5.5 meter. And so here the pump is required. Okay, circulation pump is required, that is to collect the water from the pond and feed it into the condenser shell. It is having disadvantage of flooding the steam turbine if the condensate extraction pump fails. Okay, if this pump fails to work, then there is overloading of steam. Okay, so this is the main advantage, that is flooding the steam turbine if the condensate extraction pump fails. Okay, so this is the low level counter flow term. So this, now next one is the low level parallel flow jet injector. So what is there? The rest of the parts are same, that you have to draw as your own. And just the, what is the difference here? Just see here. The exhaust steam is fed from the top of the condenser shell. Okay, what is there in the counter flow? Here the exhaust steam is on this side. But in the parallel flow, the exhaust steam is fed from the upward. Okay, from here. And here is the cooling water, that is fed from the cooling ponds. And here, this one is the main condenser shell. The perforated trays are same as there in this diagram. It's the same arrangement. And here it is the wet air pump. So what is the function of this wet air pump? That is, this pump is used to remove the air as well as to remove the condensate. Okay, so this is a wet air pump, and here it is used, here it is the dry air pump, that is to remove the air only. But here it is wet air pump, that is to remove air as well as condensate. And then that condensate is collected in the hot well and then feed to the boiler, and the extra overflow is again feed to the ponds. So the rest of the arrangement is same as in the case of counter flow type. So you have to work upon only the differences. Okay, so see here, the mixture of condensate, this one, coolant, that means the cooling water that is taken from the pond, and air are extracted with the help of wet air pump. So this mixture is extracted with the help of wet air pump here. The vacuum created in the condenser limits up to 600 mm of Hg. So this is the reading for the vacuum that is created inside the condenser shell. Now the next category is high level jet condenser, or this one is also called as barometric jet condenser. Okay, now firstly see here the diagram. Almost the rest of the parts are same. So just see here, here in this direction, the exhaust steam is taken from the turbine and fed to the condenser shell. This is the main condenser shell, or you say condenser body. Okay, so steam is fed from this side. Here it is the air extraction pump. Again, here the dry air extraction pump is used. Okay, then here is, it is a direct tall pipe to collect the condensate into the hot well. There is no pump is there. See here. Okay, the hot well is directly below the condenser shell. That means the, all the condensate, as it is properly converted, it is go to directly to the hot well without any pump. And if there is any overflow in this hot well, so that is taken to the goes to the cooling pond again. Okay, and from this hot well, by using the feed pump, it is fed to the boilers. Okay, that you can draw by yourself. And just see here the height, it is the 10.33 meters of barometric head, more than this. So it is directly collected here in the hot well. And here it is a cooling pond from where the cooling water is circulated into the condenser shell by using this circulating pump. Here it is a circulating pump. And see here, there are not the perforated trays as they are in this diagram. There are the perforated trays here. Okay? But here in the high level jet condenser, there are the baffle plates. As the same baffles that are used in the boilers also to assign the direction to the hot gases. So the baffle plates are there for the proper circulation of cooling water into the condenser shell. See here, the cooling water firstly goes here, then it moves here, then it moves here, and so on. And as the steam is lighter, it starts moving up. And when it comes in contact with this cooling water, it condenses. Okay, here the coolant and steam comes in direct contact with each other and the condensate is collected in the hot well, and air is extracted by using dry air extraction pump. So it is also called barometric jet condenser since it is placed above the atmospheric pressure equivalent to 10.33 mm of water pressure. Condensate extraction pump is not required. See here, there is no condensate extraction pump. It is not required because tailpipe has incorporated in place of it. Okay, a direct tailpipe is there, which is used to remove the condensate from the condenser shell and feed it to the directly to the hot well, from where it is fed to the boiler. Okay, so this is the arrangement for the high level jet condenser or barometric jet condenser. Now, next one is the ejector jet condenser. So see the arrangement first. So this is the ejector jet condenser. Rest of the parts are same. Okay, as they have not drawn here, but the rest of the parts are same. There is hot well, there is cooling pond, there is circulation pump. Okay, so the cooling water now is fed from this upward direction from here, and the cooling water from here, it is supplied, that is taken from the cooling pond through the circulating pump. Okay, and here it is the exhaust steam that is taken from the turbine, and a non-return valve is there. That means the steam has only one path. No backflow is there. Okay, no backflow of steam is there. So a non-return valve is connected here. And here one, what is the difference in the condenser shell? That here in place of perforated trays or baffle plates, so there are convergent, divergent nozzle arrangement. Okay, so there are the nozzle arrangements are there. We have seen the nozzles, na? The nozzles has two types of tubes types are there, but input or output from the input is of low dia and output is of large dia, like these tubes are there. These are the nozzles. Okay, these are the convergent nozzles, and at this end there is convergent divergent nozzles. These nozzles we have to study in our further syllabus also. So here at this end, there use the convergent divergent nozzles, and in the rest of the condenser shell, we have to use the convergent nozzles. Okay, and the condensate, coolant, and air through one output is collected in the hot well. And here again, to remove these collectively, we need wet air pump. Okay, so here the wet air pump is installed to collect the condensate as well as coolant as well as air. Okay, so the cooling water enters the top of the condenser at least under a head of 6 meters of water pressure with the help of centrifugal pump, or you can say the circulation pump. This system is simple, reliable and cheap. The disadvantage of mixing of condensate with the coolant. Actually, this advantage is in every type of jet condenser, because in all the categories of jet condensers, there is the mixing of condensate and coolant. So this is the main disadvantage. So this is ejector jet condenser. Okay, let's start with surface condensers, the other category. And we know that in case of surface condensers, the cooling water is there in the tubes. Okay, and steam is over these tubes for the condensation process. Okay, and here there is no direct contact between the steam and coolant. Okay, and here the condensation process takes place through the conduction and convection processes. Okay, now there are two types of surface condenser. One is we called them as simple surface condensers, and other we called as the evaporative condensers. Okay, what is there in the surface condenser? In this, the steam flows outside the network of tubes and water flows inside the tubes. Which water? That is coolant, that is taken from the pond or lake or river. Okay, that water flows through the tubes, arrangement of tubes, and the steam flows outside the network of tubes. And in case of the evaporative condenser, in this, condenser shell is omitted. There is no condenser shell. The steam passes through the condenser tubes. The water is separated while the air passes upward outside the tube. Okay, see here, the steam passes through the condenser tubes. Here in this, the surface condensers, the water is passed through the tubes. But in case of evaporative condensers, steam is passed through the condenser tubes. Okay, and the water is sprinkled over that tubes. Cold water is sprinkled over that tubes, and that steam which is present in the tubes starts condensing. Okay, so this is there in the evaporative condensers. And the number of water passes, that is a single pass, multi-pass. That this one is for the surface condenser category. See here, this is the same classification goes on for surface condensers. Two types, single pass and multi-pass, and that depends upon the number of water passes. Okay, and in case of evaporative condenser, the direction of condensate flow and the tube arrangement, depending upon that direction, there are two types of evaporative condensers. So one is downflow condenser, another one is the central flow condenser. Okay. There are two types of evaporative condensers. Now, starting with the double pass surface condensers. So this is the arrangement for the double pass surface condensers. And we know that for surface condensers, the water flows through the tubes. So these are the water tubes. See here. And from here, cooling water inlet is here. And this cooling water is taken from some pond or lake or river. Cooling water inlet is there. This enters into the water tubes, and from here it is the water box again collected here, and from this water box it again enters to the other set of tubes here. Okay, and from here there is the cooling water outlet again to that pond or lake. Okay, so there is the two set of cooling water tubes. Okay, so that's why it is called as a double pass surface condenser. And from this From the top, the exhaust steam is fed into the condenser shell that is taken from the turbine. So this is the cylindrical condenser shell is there. And here it is the wet air pump. Wet air pump means to collect the condensate as well as air. Okay, the mixture of condensate and air is collected. And see here, the cooling water is not in contact with the steam. Only when the steam flows over this cooling tubes, cooling water tubes, so it starts condensing. And the condensate is collected in lower in this portion and collected through this wet air pump. Okay, then again it is fed to the hot well. And from hot well, it is fed to the boilers, and the rest of the arrangement is same. Okay, so it consists of airtight cast iron cylindrical shell. This complete shell is there. If cooling water is impure, that is fed here in the tubes. Okay, the condenser tubes are made up of red brass. So this is the material that is generally used in the construction of this water tubes. Okay, so this is the arrangement for double pass surface condensers. Now next is the downflow surface condensers. And in case of the downflow condensers, see here, so from top, the exhaust steam is fed to the condenser shell. Okay, so this one is the condenser complete shell is there. So, and these are the condenser tubes. Okay, these are the tube arrangements, this one. And here is the baffle plate to assign the direction. And here is the air extraction pump, and here it is the separate condensate extraction pump. So here it is used dry air extraction pump. And here it is the condensate extraction pump, and which is used to remove the condensate and feed it to the hot well. So this condenser employs two separate pumps for the extraction of condensate and air. One is here and one is here. Baffles are provided so that the air is cooled to the minimum temperature before it is extracted. Okay, so what is the function for the baffle? That is to lower the temperature of air before it is removed through the air extraction pump. So it is to lower the temperature of air. The specific volume of the cooled air reduces, thereby reduces the pump capacity to about 50%. Therefore, it also reduces the energy consumption from running the air pump. So with the reducing the temperature, so specific volume is also reduced, and hence the energy consumption for running this air extraction pump is also reduced. So that is the main motive, how to reduce the consumption. Okay, so there are the arrangement of condenser tubes through which the cooling water flows. And this connected with the CL, these cooling tubes are connected with the cooling pond through the circulating pump. Now the next is the center flow surface condensers. Yes, in the center flow circuits, surface condensers. So this is the arrangement. Here is from the top, the exhaust steam is fed to the condenser shell. So here is also the arrangement of cooling tubes. Okay, and here from center of this shell, from center, the air is extracted. Okay. Air extraction pump is located at the center of the condenser tubes. Through the dry air extraction pump is there. The condensate is extracted from the bottom of the condenser. From here, the condensate is extracted using the condensate extraction pump. Okay. With the help of condensate extraction pump, and it provides the better contact of steam. Okay, so this is the arrangement of tubes in case of the central flow surface condensers. So what is the main difference? The difference mainly is the arrangement of water tubes. Okay, like in this central flow, the water tubes are arranged like this. whereas in the downflow, the water tubes are arranged like in the crisscross manners. Okay, here in the double pass, the water flow, the water tubes are arranged like this. So it is depending upon the arrangement of water tubes, there are the different categories for the surface condensers. Now the next one is the last, that is the evaporative condenser. So this is the arrangement of evaporative condenser. And see here, here there is the tube through which the steam flows. Okay, whereas in the other type of surface condenser, through the tubes the water flows. But here in case of the evaporative condenser, steam flows through the tubes. And there are the water nozzles on the top to supply or to sprinkle the cooling water from over these tubes. Okay, to sprinkle the water over these tubes, which helps in the process of condensation. So these are the gilled tubes, or you can also say the coil, condenser coil shaped. Okay, and here is the condensate extraction pump, or wet air pump is there simply, which extract the condensate as well as air. And here on the lower side, there is the water tank. Okay, from where the cooling water is supplied and sprinkled over these tubes. Okay, there is the water circulating pump is there. Okay, so this is the arrangement for evaporative condenser. So the exhaust steam is passed through the series of gilled tubes called condenser coils. Okay, we call this tube, this type of tube, as the gilled tubes or condenser coils. Thin film of cooling water trickles over these tubes. So cooling water trickles over these tubes continuously from water nozzles. So the nozzle arrangement is there. During the condensation of steam, this thin film of water is evaporated and the remainder water is collected in the water tank. Okay, when this cooling water nozzles, through nozzles, it is sprinkled over these gilled tubes, so it starts evaporating and that water is again collected in the water tank. And this steam, when converted into the water or condensate, is extracted using this pump. The condensate is extracted with the help of wet air pump. The air passing over the tubes carries the evaporated water in the form of vapor, and it is removed with the help of induced draft fan installed at the top. Okay, that air is again fed back to the, some of the air is extracted here by using this pump. And the air, which is very much lighter and goes in the upward direction, is fed to the atmosphere using these induced draft fans. Okay, so there are two methods to get the air from this complete arrangement, through the wet air pump or through the induced draft fans. So this is arrangement for evaporative condenser. Now, the merits and demerits of jet condensers. So what are the merits? First, less quantity of cooling water is required to condense the steam. For the jet condensers is there, less quantity of cooling water is required. Okay, simple in construction and low in cost, that we have already discussed. That here there is no arrangement of tubes and any other arrangement is there. So its cost is low. Its construction is simple. For the jet condenser, as the direct mixing of coolant and this steam is there, so that's why less space is required. Does not require cooling water pump. Sometimes in some of the cases, the cooling water pump is not required. Low maintenance cost is there. And what are the demerits? The condensate is a waste. That means until it is not treated properly, until it is not filtered properly, it is not fed to the boiler again. It is totally a waste, okay, which reduces the efficiency of the plant also. Less suitable for high capacity plants. Okay. Large length of pipes required, hence piping cost is high. loss of vacuum due to the leakage of air from long pipings. Less vacuum is there. Okay. Now the merits and demerits of surface condensers. Okay, surface condensers means where the direct mixing of coolant and steam is not there. Okay, either the steam flow through the tubes or the coolant flows through the tubes. So merits are no mixing of cooling water and steam, hence the condensate directly pumped into the boiler. Okay, there is no wastage of condensate. Any kind of feed water can be used. Any kind of feed water is used because it is used separately from the steam. So any kind of feed water can be used here. Develops high vacuum, therefore suitable for large power plants. Large power plants, or you said ki high capacity power plants, require less power to run the air extraction and water extraction pump. System is more efficient. And demerits, require large quantity of cooling water because it is required to be circulated continuously. Okay, system is complicated, costly, and requires high maintenance cost. Okay, why it is complicated? Because there is a set of large number of tubes inside the condenser shell. Okay, sometimes the tubes are arranged as a double pass or like central flow or okay, counter flow. Require large floor space, since it is bulky. As the large arrangement is there, so it requires a large floor space also and therefore bulky. So these are the merits and demerits for the surface condensers. So this is all for today's lecture. In today's lecture, we have studied the different types of condensers. So starting with the what are condensers, what is condensate, what is the principle behind the condensers. Okay, then the different types of condensers like jet condensers, surface condensers, then different types of jet condensers, then different types of surface condensers, then their comparison, their merits and demerits, that we have all covered in today's lecture. Okay, this is all for today's lecture. Thank you.